Hello students, today's topic is Internet Key Exchange Protocol from the chapter 4 of your module 3. Internet Key Exchange Protocol, the main goal of IKE is to establish a secure association between the two parties that wishes to communicate securely using the IPsec protocol. IKE consists of two phases, phase 1 and the phase 2. These two phases you are going to study in detail. In a phase 1, long-term keys are derived. In the first phase, an IKE SA is established, and this is going to create one secure channel upon which communicating parties can then establish multiple IPsec SA instances over a time. Phase 1 occurs rarely and it is more computationally intensive compared to your phase 2. Then the second is, in a phase 2, a short-term keys are derived for use between the two parties. This key is actually a function of long-term keys which computed in the phase 1 together with the nouns exchanged in the phase 2. Next is IPsec cookies. To prevent the DOS attacks, IKE make uses of the cookies. One cookie is created by the initiator A and the another by the responder B here. Phase 1 of IKE uses the Diffie-Hellman key exchange so that B should compute a 64-bit integer which is called as the cookie. The cookie value computed at the A, it is actually the hash function of the IP address of A, a temporary secret which is known only to B and the timestamp. Once the cookie has been created at A, it is required to send this cookie to B in all subsequent messages. The recipient of the message from A, B will check to see whether the cookie corresponds to A's IP address. If the check fails, B will abort the session establishment. Next is IKE in the phase 1. The following are the steps in the IKE phase 1. The authentication method, encryption and the hash algorithm together with the Diffie-Hellman key exchange protocol will be used here. Both the parties are authenticate themselves to the each other. Keys key A and key E are computed. These keys are used for message integrity encryption respectively in both phase 1 and the phase 2. Cookies are created at the start of the phase 1 and it will be used for the purpose of an IE connection. Phase 1 uses one of the two modes, main mode and the aggressive mode. First one we are going to see IKE phase 1 in the main mode. The motivation for introducing the main mode is to hide the identity of the sender and the receiver from the eavesdroppers. It involves total 6 messages exchanged between the initiator and the responder. IKE is going to derive the hierarchy of keys like key R, D, A and E are there, where R, D, A and E, they are going to denote the root, derived, authentication and encryption respectively. Next, the IKE phase 1, it is going to work on the three values. The first is the pre-shared secret, second one is the private signature key and third one will be the private encryption key. Here they are going, it is going to exchange the 6 messages. A and B, they are going to share a secret key which is indicated by the yes. The first message contains the cryptographic algorithm which has been proposed by A for the use in the IKE secure association. This is denoted with the SA and the CA is the cookie that will be those messages will be exchanged. Then in the third and fourth, both the side they are going to exchange the nouns and the Diffie-Hellman partial keys here. See here, this is the Diffie-Hellman keys and this will be nouns which will be exchanged here. Then after the message four that has been received, A and B, they are going to independently compute the hierarchy of the secrets keys such as key A, R and E by using the MAC. The next is using the private signature key. Here the first four messages are similar to the previous one. The difference between private signature key and the pre-shared secret key is that authentication and integrity protection of messages is affected by digital signature on the Mac A and the Mac B using their private keys there. Here they are using the digital signatures on the their identity to provide the authentication. The next one is using the private decryption keys here. The first two messages used with these options are same as the previous two cases. The main difference this option and the previous one is that both side is going to exchange their identities earlier in the message 3 and the 4. Each side they are going to generate a nouns and encrypts it with the other side's public key here. Here they are generating the nouns and it will be encrypted by the other's public. Each side are going to encrypt its identity together with the Diffie-Hellman partial key with the temporary keys KA and KB, where KA and KB is actually the hash of the nouns and the cookies there, and by using that keys you are just going to encrypt the identity and the Diffie-Hellman key exchange protocol there. Then in the message 5 and 6, each side going to transmit a MAC. The MAC key is a key which in turn it is a function of the two nouns RA and the RB. If A or B were unable to decrypt the nouns generated by the other side, then they would be able to compute the correct MAC there. Then next is IK in the second mode, that is the aggressive mode. The aggressive mode involves only three messages as shown in the figure. The identities of A and B are sent in the clear in the message 1 and B. Another aspect of IK phase 1 in the aggressive mode is that the Diffie-Hellman group is used and the group parameters are decided by the A here. A computes its partial key and send it to the B in a message 1. B has no choice but to quietly accept the group chosen by the A. So these are the three options in the aggressive mode. Just directly they are going to send their identity in the first message and then their B is going to accept the information there, and here for authentication they are going to perform this one by using the MAC value there. Then IK in the phase 2. IK phase 2, it will be used for authentication as a part of the IPsec SIM. Two parties parties participate in an IK phase 2 exchange in order to establish a new IPsec SIM. Either party can initiate this phase in which the cipher suit and the keys that compromise the new IPsec SA are agreed upon. So this is the diagram where the IK phase 2 they are going to exchange the messages. This is a quick mode here. All message encrypted using the secret key which has been computed in the previous phase. Message integrity and the data source authentication is provided by using the HMAC here. The key for the HMAC is key A, which has also computed in the phase 1. A 32-bit message ID which is used to distinguish this phase 2 session from the other that may be set up within the same IKE SA here. The MID together with the two cookies created in the phase 1, CA and the CA, are dispatched as a part of each of the three messages there. CA, CB, MID, CA, CB, MID, CA, CB and the MID is there. Both sides, their proposal for a suite of cryptographic algorithm, it will be sent. See, SAA and the SAB will be sent there. To guarantee the freshness, both sides also generate and transmit the nouns there, that is NA and the NB. These secrets are computed simultaneously by both sides and are the function of computed in the phase 1, and the nouns NA and NB will be exchanged in this phase. The integrity protected the message, each side computed a MAC on their message including the integrity protection of the both the nouns there. Even they are going to use the Diffie-Hellman partial keys, and those will be get exchanged here. Both the side will then create an entry for the new essay in their database of essays. A security policy database, it is actually used to determine whether packets sent or received should pass through the security, bypass it, or simply be dropped. Such a decision is made based on the fields which has been present in the IP and transport header. The fields are called as the selectors here, including the destination IP address, the type of the transport layer protocol, whether it might be a UDP or the TCP, and the type of the application, whether it will be indicated by the transport selection which has been used index into the SPD. The output of this lookup indicates whether security should be applied or no. If so, and if the packet is part of your IP track that already has the existing SA protocol, then the SPD returns a pointer to that SA. If an SA does not exist and it has got expired, the IKE protocol is used to establish SA between the sender and the receiver. The last point is virtual private network. A virtual private network enables the organized to communicate securely over the public shared network such as internet. A secure virtual private network uses the cryptographic techniques to provide not just confidentiality but also authentication and the message integrity. In a trusted VPN, customer traffic is also usually encrypted. Service provider has to guarantee the confidentiality of the traffic. The two most widely used VPNs are site-to-site VPN, which are used to link a multiple offices of an organization known as the intranet. Site-to-site VPN may also be used to secure an extranet, a network connecting multiple business aspects. Then the remote access VPN connect teleworks to their offices. Thank you.